Greetings, naturopath Eric Backer, author of Candida Crusher, formulator of the CanXida range of dietary supplements. Thank you for checking out my video. And I'd like to thank all my fans and patients and people that I know in various countries who've sent me emails or tried to catch up with me through Facebook or social media regarding the recent earthquake we had in New Zealand. In fact, it happened 2 minutes into my birthday a few days ago. I woke up at 2 minutes past 12 with a violent shaking of our house. Lasted for 2 minutes and it was pretty freaky when the walls are moving and all the clothes in the wardrobe are swaying and my poor cuckoo clock in the lounge, the little weights were just going really crazy and it's pretty darn scary. We've been in several earthquakes, but this was quite a vicious one indeed. So I sort of liken it to if you live in a non-earthquake zone, flying high up in the sky and then having hit with massive turbulence in an aircraft where the plane violently shakes around for 2 whole minutes. If you've ever been in that situation, you'll know that it's a very long 2 minutes indeed, okay? I mean, I've probably already spoken for 2 minutes, you know, but when something like that happens and you develop a lot of stress hormone, those 2 minutes can seem like 2 hours. So just remember that anything in life can happen at any time, all right? It's not what happens, it's how you deal with what happens, it counts. Now, we can talk about autoimmunity. I've previously completed a video already on Candida and autoimmunity, but this one's a bit different. I'm going to do a series of videos on autoimmunity in general and just talk about my experiences in the clinic with patients with autoimmunity. So, as I mentioned previously in a video, autoimmunity is about the body. You know, when we've got a condition where autoimmune disease develops, the body in a normal sense will recognize its own tissues, you know, its own organs, its blood and everything as being part of its normal self. But when autoimmunity happens, it starts to recognize certain parts of the body as foreign and will build antibodies against that and create a situation where that particular body part will be attacked. Now in rheumatoid arthritis, for example, that could be joints. In Hashimoto's thyroiditis, that could be the thyroid. In celiac disease, it could be the small intestine, you know. There's about 70-odd autoimmune diseases. I'll read a couple of them out to you here out of a book. Addison's disease, you know, which is complete adrenal insufficiency. Ankylosing spondylitis, which is more common in men than in women, which is one of the rare autoimmune diseases. Most autoimmune diseases, in fact, seem to be more commonly occurring in females than in males. Autoimmune hepatitis, celiac disease, Crohn's disease, diabetes type 1, Graves' disease, overactive thyroid, Hashimoto's disease, underactive thyroid, multiple sclerosis, you may know some of these names, Parkinson's disease, psoriasis, Raynaud's disease, rheumatoid arthritis, vitiligo, ulcerative colitis, systemic lupus, they've all got funny names, but basically what it is the immune system attacking different parts of the body, creating specific kinds of diseases. There's about 70 different autoimmune diseases. But for an autoimmune disease really to occur in the body, there are 3 main triggers. I'm just reading some of my notes I've made here. 3 main triggers that we're looking at here. Genetics often play a role in autoimmunity. Not always, but in many cases, you will find a relation of yours had an autoimmune disease. We find that, for instance, in type 1 diabetes quite a bit. But we also find it in Hashimoto's or Graves' disease, in the thyroid autoimmune conditions. We will often find that a grandmother had it or an auntie had it, you know, or some relative had this condition. We also need a trigger. So something triggered off this autoimmune condition. Could be a toxin, could be a virus, could be a heavy metal, could be too much sunlight, could be lack of vitamin D. Or in the case of a patient today, she had 2 abusive relationships with guys, which were terrible over a period of multiple years. She grew up in a relationship with a father abusing the wife, you know, physically and emotionally for many years. And the poor girl grew up in that household. And then she went on to have abusive relationships herself on 2 counts. By the time she's 25, she's got 2 autoimmune diseases. Surprise, surprise. I've had a patient in the South Island of New Zealand who went through a horrific earthquake in 2011 where she lost her husband, she lost her house, she lost her business, she lost everything. 4 years later, autoimmune disease, Sjögren's disease, scleroderma. Interesting. Is there a connection there? Well, we can't say that it caused it, but we can almost certainly conclude that the stress in both of these ladies' situations had a very powerful helping hand. I've spoken many times about stress before. If you have stress long enough and severe enough, it's going to wreck your immune function. That's going to increase your susceptibility. It's going to decrease your resistance. It's going to make you more prone to a pathogen. One of my patients today had a very stressful book publishing business for many years, was involved in performing arts, had a very dysfunctional relationship, did quite a lot of extensive overseas travel, got some digestive problems, had antibiotics on top of that, rheumatoid arthritis developed. So I could go on and on for ages with you about hundreds of cases I've seen over the years of people with autoimmune diseases. And in most cases, we can find that there was some kind of stress or some kind of drug or toxin underpinning this condition. Autoimmune disease is the second leading killer of women worldwide. It's a serious condition. Many doctors, in my opinion, pay lip service to this problem. They just put patients on drugs, anti-inflammatories, antibiotics, antidepressants, any kind of anti-pill that's close at hand. And this will shut the patient up and get them out of the room, because no interest is in really trying to determine why the autoimmune disease developed and what could be done to stop the inflammatory condition from going on. So there you have a little bit about autoimmune disease. The third thing that you need to look at is leaky gut. That's the third thing I forgot to mention. So genetics to a degree, trigger, and leaky gut. So something will initiate the response and something will keep it going. So we want to shut the door on the leaky gut. Because many people who develop autoimmune disease unfortunately get put on pharmaceutical medications which increases their already leaking gut, which increases the inflammatory response, increases the susceptibility towards getting more pathogens into the body, more dietary triggers, which increases the inflammatory pool, which increases the need for more drugs. So you're in a catch-22. And that's enough for this video. I'll catch up with you in the next video, and we're going to go into a little bit more detail with some particular types of autoimmune diseases. I've done some presentations on them over the years, so I'll try and pull some of these autoimmune conditions apart a little bit and explain to you a bit about my experiences in treating them and some of the resolutions I've seen as a result. So thanks for tuning into this video. Don't forget to click on the link below if you haven't got my Candida report. Catch up in the next video. Thank you.